Jal Gosain, sir, welcome to the Bombay Sappers bicentenary celebrations. You are one of the most decorated Bombay Sappers and you had a checkered career in the army. Please tell us about your association with the Bombay Sappers.
Thank you. Greetings and congratulations to the Bombay Sappers for the bicentenary celebrations. I have pleasant memories of many Ghazni days and VC days celebrated in the center in my 38 years of service in the army. At the outset, I'd like to say that I am an average person coming from a humble family. I was born in a remote village in Garhwal. My father was a treasury officer in UP government accounts department. I got my education in government schools in UP wherever my father was posted. I passed my matriculation examination in first division and was studying in class 12, where I had also joined Provincial Education Corps, imparting military training. One day, my father asked me if I would like to join the army, and if so, I should apply for entrance examination of Joint Services Wing of the National Defence Academy. I agreed to try. I appeared in the written examination and qualified. During the service selection board, I had a number of candidates from public and English medium schools like Doon School and RIMC. But to my surprise, I was selected. I joined the Joint Services Wing of NDA at Clementown in January 1950 and passed out in 1952 as a senior cadet captain. Thereafter, I did my training in Nitti Wing, IMA, and passed out in December 1953 as senior under officer. I had given my choice of arm as Corps of Engineers and was lucky to be commissioned in the Bombay Sappers. I joined BGN Center at Karki, Pune in January 1954 and was detailed for YO's course at CME. In my 38 years of service, I had 15 postings, mainly with troops, of which 5 postings were in field oblique operational area and 2 staff appointments. Each posting of mine was full of opportunities, challenges, achievements, and rewards. I will briefly narrate my journey in the army as a Bombay Sapper. After completing the YO's course, my first posting was to in 19 Field Company located at Dragmula in the Kashmir Valley in July 1955. In 19 Field Company, as a young officer, second lieutenant, I was lucky to get many independent assignments. Some of them were broadening of road Bandipur to Kanzalwan over Rajdan Pass from Class 3 to Class 5. Construction of 120 feet Class 3 common suspension bridge at Gurez over River Kishan Ganga. Clearing of mines laid in 1947-48 on the ridge across River Kishan Ganga at Gurez and many others. These were completed successfully by my platoon, which gave me tremendous confidence and satisfaction. The platoon JCO and sappers were full of enthusiasm and confidence and supported and guided me. I was detailed for engineer degree course at CME, Pune in 1955, which I completed in first division in 1958. During the engineer's degree course, I volunteered for Parafield Company. I was posted to 411 Parafield Company, and after intense probation period under Major M.C. Gupta, later on Major General, I was absorbed in the paras in June 1958. After para course, I earned my maroons, served in the para field company till December 59. My first posting to BEGN Center was in December 1959 as Chief Training Officer Military, CTOM, in Training Battalion 1. I was also detailed for Joint Land Air Warfare course at Secunderabad and PT course at Pune. While I was busy in my duties in the center, Early in December 1961, Major Rastogi, OC 411 Parapeel Company, landed at my residence. He handed over an order for me to be attached to 411 Parapeel Company, which was moving for Goa operations. He left a jeep for me with instructions to join the company at Belgaum. On reaching the company, I was made the platoon commander. The platoon was to support 1st Sikh Light Infantry for advance on Axis Belgaum, Mapasa, Panjim. The intelligence reports had indicated that the bridge approximately 80 feet was demolished by the Goan army at Asanora. We carried a 110 feet belly bridge for this task. However, on reaching the site, we found that the gap was 130 feet and not 80 feet. As the water level of the tidal river at that time was low, we constructed a port causeway with local material and helped the column to cross the river. The advance was being led by tanks, and I with my advance party followed them. At one point, finding mines on the road, the complete convoy stopped. With the help of sappers in the advance party, we cleared mines on the road. Finding no mines for some distance, I asked the tank to advance. They were hesitant to move as they feared more mines on the road. I sat on top of the leading tank and told them to move, assuring them that I would be looking for the mines. This gave them confidence and they advanced. En route, the road was blocked at one point by felling trees. Both sides of the road were mined. The leading tank tried to bypass the obstacle. I was able to stop it in time. A mine was only 4 feet ahead of the tank. After clearing the road, the mines advance was resumed and we reached the river bank by evening. Panjim was just across. The river was crossed by commanding civil crafts. Platoon. After capture of Panjim, I reverted back to the center and was appointed group sports officer. I trained the group teams and especially new gymnastic team. After intense training, the gymnastic team took part in All India competition at Patiala and in the first attempt only won the team championship. I was detailed for JC course thereafter and after completing the course, I was posted as OC 23 Field Company on promotion in 1963. 23 Field Company was deployed with Border Roads Organization and was constructing roads in central Bhutan from Hathisar to Tongsa. The company constructed 220 feet Bailey Suspension Bridge on the border. The company was ordered to move to Rangia in Assam to give engineer support to 8th Mountain Division. 8th Mountain Div had moved from Nagaland and had no engineer troops. A large number of operational works were undertaken by the company. On raising of the divisional engineers, my company joined 647 Corps Troop Engineers, commanded by Lieutenant Colonel M.C. Gupta, at Rangapara North in Assam. The company carried out bridging and field engineering training at that place. Thereafter, the company moved to Zero. Thereafter, the company moved to Zero in Nifa, now Arunachal Pradesh, to construct prefab accommodation for the battalion and also constructed a 400 feet Bailey suspension bridge over River Kamla on Road Zero along for the Border Roads Organization. After completing the task, the company was moved to Along and joined 647 Corps Troop Engineers carrying out engineering tasks. Thereafter, in 1965, I was posted to 102 Engineer Regiment as second in command. The regiment was newly raised at Pune and had 21, 96 and 97 field companies under it. The regiment moved from Pune to Ranaghat on East Pakistan border as 9 infantry engineers. Lieutenant Colonel, later Major General A.M. Joblekar was the CO. Major General, later Lieutenant General P.C. Bhagat, Victoria Cross, was the GOC of the division. General Bhagat had won his Victoria Cross while serving in 21 Field Company in World War II. After ceasefire, the regiment moved to Ramgarh in Bihar. I appeared for the intense examination of the Defence Service Staff College and qualified. I attended Defence Service Staff College in the year 1967. On completion of Defence Service Staff College, while as other officers were posted as BM, DQ, GSO2, etc., I was posted as GSO2 Intelligence, 8th Mountain Division in Nagaland. My wife asked me about my posting. I told her that I am the only intelligent officer in this course and hence I've been posted as GSO2 Intelligence, 8th Mountain Division. 8th Mountain Div was engaged in counterinsurgency operations in Nagaland and Manipur against the Naga and other hostiles. We were gathering information and intelligence about the hostiles, their movements, their camps, and their actions for taking action against them. We had cultivated a number of informers, including a splinter group of Naga hostiles. A Naga hostile gang under self-styled General Mao Angami, Chief of Naga Army, was returning from China after training and was located at Burma. The gang entered Nagaland from Burma. Many attempts to ambush the gang did not materialize. The gang was then guided to a Naga hostile camp of the splinter group and General Mao Angami was captured. I was awarded Chief of Army Staff Commendation Card for my services in 8th Mountain Div as GSO2 Intelligence. My tenure as GSO2 Intelligence was After my tenure as GSO2 Intelligence, I was posted as Commanding Officer 102 Engineer Regiment in 1970 on promotion. The regiment had just moved to Ramgarh from Nipa. The regiment was put through rigorous training for the new role. Bridging training camp was held at Allahabad. The div troops and brigades were trained in watermanship. In 1971, the division and the regiment moved to Barakpur at Calcutta. The div and regiment thereafter moved to field location at Ranaghat for impending operations in East Pakistan. Division was deployed to capture Jessore and Khulna in southwestern region of East Pakistan. The regiment was fully prepared for the operations with large quantities of bridging. The regiment moved to field location at Ranaghat for impending operation in East Pakistan. Division was deployed to capture Jessore and Khulna in southwestern region of East Pakistan. The regiment was fully prepared for the operations with large quantities of bridging, drafting, track laying, and other engineering equipment. During the operations, the regiment supported advance of the division by constructing bridges, rafts, roads, beaching mines, and other engineering tasks. As the magnitude of engineer task was vast, additional engineer regiment, 268 engineer regiment of Bombay Sappers was allotted to the division. All engineering tasks were done jointly by both the regiments. The main route, Bangaon, Jessore, was heavily mined and defended by the army, by the Pakistan army. A cross-country route in north, Baira, Garipur, Durga Barkhatti, Jessore was taken. The main tasks undertaken were construction of 370 feet Bailey Bridge at Alamganga. First operational Krupman Bridge 220 feet at Baira over River Ichhamati was constructed by the regiment in record time. track laying on marshy banks of river, minefield beaching. 1,000-meter deep minefield was pieced at Durgavadkatti for capture of Jasaur. A number of villages on way to Jasaur were constructed. Rafting to cross several rivers in on way to Khulna had been undertaken. Main road Bangaon Jasaur was opened by constructing bridges and clearing of obstacles after capture of Jasaur. After capture of Jasaur and Khulna, the Pak Army surrendered. Brigadier M.C. Hayat, Commander 107 Infantry Brigade, Pakistan Army, signed the instrument of surrender at Khulna on 17 December 1971. Bangladesh operations are called Battle of the Bridges. BBC correspondent visited Jasaur and praised the work of the sappers and commented, "I crossed the rivers by boats in the morning and returned by bridges in the evening." In the Battle of Jasaur and Khulna, Lieutenant Ahuja had his ankle blown up in a minefield. 20 sappers were injured during the operations. The regiment lost 6 brave sappers during the battle. We pay our homage to the martyrs and salute them. The regiment earned 14 awards in this operation, with 2nd Lieutenant Tamal Roy getting Veer Chakra and 2nd Lieutenant Murthy and 4 others getting Sena Medal. There were 6 mention and dispatches. I was awarded BSM. Major General Dalbir Singh, DOC 9 Infantry Division, wrote, This was in my view the utmost that a commander could expect from such a well-trained, devoted and courageous troops. Throughout the operations, 102 Engineer Regiment held 9 infantry teams literally to move and fight on riverine and marshy terrain of Bangladesh. Military analysts all over the world still wonder how the Indian sappers achieved this miracle using outdated World War II equipment. Lieutenant General Bhagat Victoria Cross in a letter to me wrote, "Now that the Indian Army is fully engaged in battle against Pakistan, I am confident that the Bombay Sappers units will cover themselves with glory and keep the high traditions of the group. I heard of your exploits from the divisional commander. My congratulations to you and the regiment. Fond regards." After I was posted as GSO-1 operations in the ENC branch in May 1972. After successful command of the regiment. Had good opportunity to interact with MO Directorate, planning for operations and aid to civil authorities for 2.5 years. I was posted as GSO-1 operations in ENC's branch in May 1972, after successful command of the regiment. Had good opportunity to interact with MO Directorate, planning for operations and aid to civil authorities for 2.5 years. I was nominated for higher command course, which I attended in 1975. After the higher command course, I was posted as CWE Dehradun. This was my first exposure to MES. CWE Dehradun had 4 Gs, including 1 Project G and 2 independent AGs, with variety of users such as Indian Military Academy, regimental centers, Air Force including Airfield, Naval Hydrographic Office, Research and Development Organizations, and Ordnance Factory. We also constructed new Rashtrapati Ashya residence for the President of India at Dehradun, for which we got appreciation letter from the President. I had a very satisfying tenure of 2 years with MES. On 14 January 1978, I was posted as Chief Engineer, Project Sevak, on promotion as Colonel. Project Sevak was constructing and maintaining roads in Nagaland and Manipur. It was a very satisfying tenure. Though being in insurgency area, the hostiles did not interfere in our work. In May 1979, I was promoted as Brigadier and posted to Project Vartak. Project Vartak was constructing and maintaining roads in Nipa, now Arunachal Pradesh. Headquarter Project Vartak was located at Tezpur, where Eastern Base Workshop and Eastern Store Division were also based. These came under Project Vartak for administration and discipline. There was general unrest among the GRAP personnel in the BRO who wanted parity with the army. Sammelans were organized to explain that the case for improvement of service conditions had been initiated, and they were also governed by the Army Act, and as such, indiscipline in the post cannot be tolerated. However, one day, GRAP personnel of the Eastern Base Workshop and Eastern Store Division gathered outside the office of the Chief Engineer shouting slogans. I warned them that they were violating the discipline and will be arrested if they did not disperse. They continued shouting slogans. Preparations to deal with this type of situation had been made, and about 1,000 personnel were arrested and taken into custody. Majority of them regretted for their action and asked for pardon. About 50 of them were punished under Army Act of the Civil Service Conduct Rules. I took this decision to maintain discipline in the force and was fully aware of the consequences. The case took a political turn and went right up to the Prime Minister. Fortunately, he directed, "Let the law take its own course." The case was also taken up to the courts by the GRAP personnel. The case went right up to the Constitution Bench of the Supreme Court, which upheld the action taken by me. As the workload in Project Vartak increased manifold, a new Project Udayak was raised. I was awarded ABSM for my service in Project Vartak. I was posted as Commandant BGN Center in December 1980. I was the first commandant in the rank of Brigadier. Commandant BGN Center had additional responsibility of Station Commander Karki and President Cantonment Board. Every year, Southern Command Ad Hoc Engineer Brigade was raised by the center, which took part in the command exercise in Rajasthan. I took part in this exercise for 3 consecutive years. During the period, the recruit strength increased manifold and Training Battalion 3 was raised. My full attention was on imparting good training. VC Day, now Group Day, was organized on grand scale for all the 4 years of my tenure, as I considered it to be part of training. Bombay Sapper War Memorial was adopted as crest and memento. Bombay Sapper song, "Hum Bombay Sapper Hain," was composed and started, and Bombay Sapper History, Tradition of Valor, was published. I served as commandant for 3.5 years. In April 1984, I was posted as Commander Jalandhar Sub Area. The sub area was looking after all the administrative and static units in North Punjab and Himachal Pradesh in support of the field formations. During Operation Blue Star at Amritsar, we provided administrative support to all the units inducted in for the operations. On Sapper Score Day, we donated a park called Sapper Park for the residents of the Jalandhar Cant. After sub-area, I was posted as Chief Engineer, Eastern Command in 1986. Thereafter, in June 1987, I was posted as Director General, Border Roads, and I was promoted as Lieutenant General in June 89 in the same appointment. I was DGBR for 4.5 years, and the organization received high praise for its good work. The service conditions of the grep personnel were also greatly improved. I was elected as Colonel Commandant of the Bombay Sappers on 8th November 1980. I retired from service on 31st August 1991, 28 years back. I was awarded PVSM in January 1992 on retirement. Looking back at my 38 years of service with satisfaction of having done my duties in the best traditions of the Bombay Sappers.
General Gosain, sir, your journey with the Bombay Sappers is very encouraging. On this occasion of bicentenary, what message you would like to give to our young and not so young Bombay Sappers?
I do not know if one can draw any lessons from my service in the Bombay Sappers. An average person can do well in the army. I retired 28 years back, and as such, I do not know if my message has any meaning for the present day army. I had served with Lieutenant General P.C. Bhagat, Victoria Cross, Major General M.C. Gupta, Major General A.M. Joglekar and Major General S.C. Kapoor, the Bombay Sappers, and followed their footsteps. The ethos of the Bombay Sappers, that is simplicity, sincerity, honesty, and hard work, and courage were responsible for my success. Loyalty to seniors and juniors is important. I have experienced that if you have faith in your seniors and subordinates, they will never let you down. Thank you.
It was indeed a pleasure listening to the motivating story of the Bombay Sappers. Thank you, sir.